Welcome to another episode of Erik Wait Whisky Studies, and in this series, I'm sharing my trip to the UK, in which in July 2019, I spent 2 days in London, England, and 2 weeks traveling around Scotland visiting distilleries, meeting up with fellow whisky tubers, and I spent 2 days at the Edinburgh Whisky Academy earning a diploma in single malt Scotch whisky. Well, after going to Glen Moray Distillery, I headed over to Glen Moray Distillery. Glen Moray Distillery is a Speyside distillery located on the banks of the River Lossie in Elgin. It was founded in 1897, originally as West Brewery, which was run by Robert Thorne and Sons, and was converted to a distillery with 2 stills. It currently has 3 wash stills and 3 spirit stills. In 1910, the distillery was closed due to a recession. In the 1920s, it was purchased by the owners of Glen Moray Distillery, the McDonald and Muir families. In 2008, it was sold to Le Martin Quesset, France's second largest spirits group. So the distillery really focuses, or I think specializes in wine cask finished whiskeys. And I think they do an absolutely fantastic job. Some of them are, I would say, really reasonably priced. And they, even though they tend to be a lower ABV, most of them, they really deliver in flavor from the wine cask. But before I get into this special bottle, which I brought back from the distillery, a distillery-owned exclusive, this is the Peated PX cask bottle. Let me show you some photos and video of my tour around the distillery. I've been in your waters. Alrighty, so after we did a tour, we headed over to the tasting room, which is also right next to a cafe, and I like it when they have a cafe. We tasted a 10-year-old, which is bottled at 40% alcohol by volume. It is finished in a Chardonnay cask, sells for about $24 here in the United States. Then I tasted the Cabernet Sauvignon cask. This is a non-age statement. It is bottled at 40% alcohol by volume and sells for about $27 here in the United States. So, I mean, those two alone are really, really reasonably priced. And yeah, it isn't a big punch in the face of powerful, you know, alcohol. Yeah, it's a lower ABV. A lot of whiskey people tend to stick their nose up to lower ABVs. But I thought they did a really good job in terms of having a high quality price ratio under $30. How many Scotch whiskeys out there can you recommend that you know of that are under $30? I mean, that's really, really, really hard. And I think they deliver a lot of flavor in their use of the wine cask finishes. Then I tasted the Peated PX finished cask. The Glen Moray Peated PX finished cask is a distillery edition. It was distilled in 2010 and bottled in 2018, making it 8 years old. It was aged in bourbon cask and then transferred to a PX finished cask. This is cask number 9997. Only 640 bottles were produced. It is bottled at 55.8% alcohol by volume and is available in 700 milliliters and sells for £60 in the UK, and which is equivalent to about $76 here in the United States. Alrighty. I really, really, really like this whiskey. It is dense and dark and full of flavor. First, let's check out the color on that. Sort of a dark amber to it, but there's just, I don't know if you can pick it up on the camera or not, but there is a slight tinge of red, which I kind of get from most wine finish casks. It is dark and broody. I get prunes, blackberries, black currants, cassis, plums, chocolate covered cherries, vanilla, caramel. The smoke, because it is peated, the smoke is interwoven with all the aromas. So it's not like a big punch of peat in the face. And it's also not just a big fruit bomb with sweetness, although it is kind of sweet. The smoke and the chocolate and the fruit are really interwoven with each other, which I really, really like. On the palate. Wow. This is unbelievably intense. This is probably one of the darkest, most broody, dark chocolate. Dark chocolate wrapped around blackberries and blueberries and cassis and currants. Cassis and currant notes isn't something that I use to describe a whiskey very often. That's what I would use to describe usually a Cabernet Sauvignon. On the back end, some caramels, brown sugar, almost like a molasses or a maple syrup note. So this whiskey is super dark, it's super intense. It's super dense and concentrated in flavor, and it is also sweet. This is a sweet whiskey. It is, for the most part, the same up front, in the middle, and the back end, although what tends to linger around is actually some lighter notes of chocolate and caramels is what sticks around, and the peat or the smoke has sort of dissipated. I really, really like this whiskey, but this is sort of in a category that I would put it in. Like after dinner and you want something sweet, that's sort of in the category that I would put this in. Different whiskeys and different wines have their different occasions and different places. This is not something on a hot summer day, you're going to be kicking back out on the porch and drinking it. This is on a cold winter day after dinner and you just want something, maybe a place where we might have chocolate pudding or a German chocolate cake, something like that, something really, really deep and rich. That's the word I'm looking for. This is a very rich whiskey. Absolutely fantastic. And I actually really, really like this on ice or with a little bit of water. Not only does it sort of take away the tingle of the alcohol, but the flavors seem to meld together even more, and it has a nice sort of silky, glossy texture to it. I really, really, really like this on ice. And at this ABV, it can definitely take a little bit of ice. Alrighty, so I really liked the tour of the distillery. I thought the people there were super hospitable. But one of the additional things that I really like there is I like distilleries that have cafes. Because you're traveling around and after visiting a distillery, maybe you want to grab a bite to eat. But one of the things they had at this cafe, which is a little bit different, is they actually had Scotch whiskey ice cream. And I definitely had to have some. That was absolutely delicious as well. Kind of hard to find whiskey ice creams. A while back, I did a review of a bourbon and praline ice cream, which was very, very good. So if you're ever visiting this distillery, you definitely want to check out this bottle. And if you got the time and you can spare the calories, check out the Scotch ice cream. It was absolutely fantastic. Alrighty, That's it for this review. If you subscribe to this channel, and thank you very much. If you haven't yet subscribed, but you like watching my videos, I would greatly appreciate it if you would subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up. Share with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, and other social networking channels. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please do so. And you're going to want to ring the bell below in order to be notified when I go live or post a new video. All right. Until next time. Cheers.
Hey, if you like my review, be sure to check out these other whiskey videos.